Hey guys, what's going on? It's iRocker77. Today I've got a review for you of Warthog. So I want to start out by saying, if you watched my previous channel, I had a review on Warthog before. Okay? First thing. That's the first thing. Next thing is, I have been doing my PlayStation 3 stuff, and will continue to do my PlayStation 3 things on the TV. However, Warthog is an online-only game, and I don't think that it would work for me to show you. It's just not going to work correctly if I show you on there. So, let's start out. Sony Computer Entertainment, it's multiplayer only. Before you go out and buy this, do not let this fool you. On the multiplayer only, it says online, LAN, and split screen. This is not a split screen game. In order to play split screen, you either have to join a split screen game or create a split screen game. However, other online players can join your game. It's still an online game. Now, if you lock it to your friends, then you could play split screen with, like, two of your friends who are at one of your friends' house, and then, like, you and your friend that's at your house. Okay, I mean, you know, you can figure it out. So, this is one of my favorite games for the PlayStation 3. Let me tell you why. First off, the online is really, really great. I mean, like, the online is just crazy awesome. Because that's what the game is. And if the online play wasn't good, then the game would suck. Okay? I mean, that's just how it would be. So, the online play is really great. And the thing that keeps you going is not the online play. Because on a lot of online games, you're not necessarily playing for a rank. You're just playing to get more points and playing because it's fun. I'm not saying Warthog isn't fun, but there is so much gameplay in this game. I'm not even gonna look, but however much this game is worth, it's worth it. I would pay $100 for this thing, okay? Because you've got booster packs that you can add on. You've got 3 booster packs, okay? Just released a new one. 3 booster packs that are just new maps. Then you already have like 7 maps or something that have like little tiny game fields in each map. Okay? So then you have all those maps to choose from. Okay? That in itself is enough to keep you playing for a long, long time. Then you've got options to be an airman. You can be on the ground. You can be in a tank. You can be in a car. Okay, now, you're probably thinking, okay, well, that's gay. You can do that. It's not stupid because when you're, like, in a tank, if you get so many kills in a tank, then you start getting awards for the tank, and you start wanting to play more in the tank. If you do the same thing in a plane, you want to get to do more in the plane. So it's not like other games where you can just like hop in a tank, shoot someone, get out, okay, and then go. Like, you have several different options, okay? So then you have a rank, okay? And the game requires you to have a certain amount of points and a certain amount of kills and a certain amount of, and then you have to achieve other awards. And there's a ton of awards, okay? Like, I mean, a ton. Like, a huge, an outrageously huge amount of awards. And in order to rank, in order to get your rank up, you have to earn certain awards and get a certain amount of points, okay? So, that is what the gameplay is. So that is a ton of gameplay, okay? Now, any game, like I was saying this before, like about the online, any game can have a lot of gameplay, but if the game sucks, then why does it matter if it has a lot of gameplay? I mean, I could sit on my iPhone playing some crappy game that has 300 levels, but who cares if it has 300 levels if it's not fun? The reason why I think this game is fun is because of the depth of the gameplay. There's several different reasons why this could be, but the one that I'm choosing is going to be the depth of the gameplay. And what I mean by the depth of the gameplay is that you have, because of all the options that you have, you get to a point in the game where you're like, not even, like, my kills, my stuff, my specialty is capture the flag, okay? And I'm going to get to that in a minute, because there's a ton of different, there's also a ton of different modes of play, like capture the flag, deathmatch, team deathmatch. I'm just going to, and so, that, my specialty is capture the flag. I'm really good at getting the flag, but I'm also really good on foot. That's where I get most of my kills. Then you've got some of these guys who are up in planes getting 30 points a game, 60 points a game, because they're so good in planes. I'm not very good at a plane in this game. And some people might say, well, that's stupid. I mean, like, how can you not be good in a plane? This game's about planes. No, it's not, okay? This is no Call of Duty, Halo, whatever you want to call it, for, like, a land game. But who cares? It's a good game, okay? So if you're looking for a game with a lot of gameplay and fantastic online play, I really, really highly recommend Warhawk. This is an amazing game. I really think that you should go out and get this game. So guys, this is iRocker77. I'm going to sign out here, and I will see you guys in my next video, which is actually going to be a case review. So I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.